Paul and Drew are championing the underrated Porsche 914, the world's first mass-market mid-engined roadster.
Yes. What a noise!
But at £12,000, this so-called poor man's Porsche is too rich for Drew.
I think $10,000 grab you.
You're getting closer.
Okay, I think we'll be final one, like one bid on it, sort of 11 grand, and that'd be it. Because I've got 10 grand to spend on this car, for sure.
11?
11, today. Done. Drive it away, gone.
Okay.
Deal?
Deal.
Thank you very much, Barry.
Great stuff. That's okay. 29 years ago, I bought my first Porsche, a white 914, for a grand. So 29 years later, I buy another one for £11,000. I don't know what the maths is, but that's gone up considerably, hasn't it?
If you just make it look a bit nicer, I think it will appeal not only to people that want a 914, but to people who've got that complete Porsche collection and want, basically, a baby 911.
With the car safely back at the workshop, Michael and the team can get to work. Job number one is to strip the car ready for a respray. Which means in Conwy, Drew has a decision to make.
We're trying to shake off this long-held, stupid image that this is a poor man's Porsche. So, how do we turn this into a premium product? We use one of the colours from one of the big boys, one of the 911 colours. So I've got a picture of a 911 here in the colour that I want to use, which is this wonderful metallic green. I think it's going to look superb. I also want to go with a fuchsia wheel, so we're going to put some of those on it as well. Overall, the car is going to be sensational. The colour's a family colour, so people go, that's a great colour. Yeah, it's a 911 colour. Yeah, it's a Porsche. There's nothing wrong with it. The people who say, oh, it's not a real Porsche, really? Show me yours, because I can guarantee they haven't got one. That's the difference. People who know, know. This is a great car, and they're massively undervalued.
As the 914 was developed with Volkswagen, it was fitted with a four-cylinder air-cooled VW engine. But the one in Drew and Paul's car needs work. To make sure it's done right, Drew's taking it to an air-cooled specialist in Lancashire.
James has come very highly recommended by a friend of mine who said, 914 engine, James, that's good enough for me. So, never been to his workshop, but we will go and have a look.
JS Autocare is run by James Averall and his partner, Kerry Kennedy. And both are air-cooled engine fanatics.
I love the engine sound, the loud, noisy, clattery noise of them.
The smell of oil.
Yeah, the smell of oil. Gear oil, don't get me started on gear oil.
Drew has sent their engine on ahead, and James has already done some initial investigations.
Hello, James. Hiya. How are you doing?
OK.
Right, our engine.
Yes.
So, I can see you've got it stripped down.
Yep.
Give us the good news, give us the bad news.
It has been messed with. Probably on numerous occasions over the years, so it's probably not been running the best, which causes other things to wear as well. So
what you'll find with a lot of the cars that come from the States is they have a culture of just using the mechanic down the road. They just drop it off, the guy quickly gets the bits, bolts them on, and that, and it'll work to an extent. With these air-cooled engines, you need to be a specialist. You need to take these cars to people who understand what it takes to make them run correctly.
As James digs deeper, there is evidence that poor quality work has caused major damage.
Is that water?
Yes.
Why has it got water in, in the engine?
No idea.
It's ringing alarm bells. The engine looks really dirty, covered in oil. It's going to be full rebuild. I think it's worse than we imagined. So, price now, full rebuild.
Yeah.
What's it going to cost?
Roughly speaking, from what I've seen so far, you're around about £4,000.
I completely understand if you find anything else in there, it's fine. It's just, I just want it dead right.
See what we can do then.
Yeah. Again, no pressure. Thank you, James.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
See ya.
It's going to cost a good few thousand to put this right, but we have to go with that engine. That's the correct engine for the car.
We're going to end up with a great car. Are we going to end up with a great car that's going to make us some money? I'm really now not sure.
Let's just do it. it's now, it's like, how can I put it? Now the gloves are off, we can't do anything.
Though the engine troubles are a setback, Drew's plan to improve the 914's image is taking a big step forward at the paint shop. His metallic Lindgren green paint, borrowed from the more expensive 911, is already transforming the look. At the workshop, the finished engine is returned to its rightful home. And with details like the simpler European bumpers, Fuchs-style wheels, and bespoke luggage in place, the car is complete. The question is whether Drew thinks they've done enough to rid the car of its poor man's Porsche reputation.
The 914 is a classic, and if you don't think that, you really don't know cars. They just got a bad reputation because they became very cheap, and because it had a VW engine in it, which was deemed to be, you know, not as good. The first Porsches, you know, there was an awful lot of VW DNA in those, and there was nothing wrong with those, was there? And they're now worth fortunes.
Hello, mate.
Are you doing all right?
Look at what we made.
Superb.
Isn't it fabulous?
Wow.
Some projects you don't know exactly where they'll end up. You have an idea in your mind, but the execution turns out to be better than you even thought. And this car is that. This Porsche is beautiful. The colour, the stance, the wheels, the interior, everything just really hangs together. I know we transform a lot of cars, but that one is almost unrecognisable from the car we bought, isn't it?
That's really good. I'm very, very pleased with that.
I think between us, we've chosen some good stuff. So walking you through, I think the bumpers just make it. I think the early bumpers are so much cleaner and prettier than the later bumpers. Yeah, yeah.
Which
cleaner.
I chose.
Are you going to say you chose everything?
Nope, just the bits I chose.
Let's just acknowledge that you're a genius at the beginning.
You carry on. Go on. Keep going.
Nice colour.
Who chose that? Thank you.
You chose it. This Let me just pop this engine for you. So that's all been rebuilt, redone. The hell hole is no longer hellish. It's heavenly now. It's the heavenly hole. And this I do really like, as well as obviously exquisite paintwork everywhere. We've got, this is very nice, mate, I have
like
to say.
That.
I love the colour choice.
Yes.
Aren't these beautiful bags, though?
Really, really nice. What I wanted to do was just evoke the era.
Yeah.
And then the green to match up.
Yeah, I like the green.
They're a great thing to sell a car, aren't they?
They really are.
It's got something that I really like. It's got that thing that when you pull up somewhere, people be like, wow. Wow, look at this. Haven't seen one of those for ages. Wow, God, that's good, that's good, that's good. All of the choices on the car have made one whole, which has added up to something really rather special.
And we're not in a bad place with the cash. So we paid 11 grand for the car. It was 22-ish. But...
no wonder it's good.
It's very good. But I do think that is a £24,000 car.
That's an easy, easy seller.
It's faultless, isn't it?
Yeah. And I think if you're a Porsche collector and you want one of these, this is a good bet.
I think so.